Come on, give them some glory right where you're at. Give them some praise right where you're at. Hallelujah. Come on, he's worthy. Amen. He is awesome. Praise his name. Hallelujah. Come on, you can do better than that. We don't need no music. Come on, let's glorify the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Lord, you are worthy to be praised, oh God. Lord, we honor you today, oh God. Holy, you are wonderful. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Praise the Lamb of God. You may have your seats. Amen. We're going to be blessed. Amen. The women of faith are in the house. Amen. And they're going to come and they're going to minister. Amen. Can I have them come forward, please?
Amen.
Amen. You guys ready? Pastor Roberto and Sister Noelia, can you please make your way to the front, please? Por favor. God is good. Hay poder en el nombre de Jesús Cristo. Hallelujah. Praise God. Come on, you can do better than that. Hallelujah. The women of faith, amen. Praise God. Every mighty man needs a woman of faith. Can you say amen? Hello. Hello, somebody. God is a good God. We're going to continue with our service, and I'm going to ask Brother Edgar to come. We're going to present some certificates of appreciation.
Amen.
You know, God has taken me a long way.
Amen.
In a short period of time.
Amen.
And I'm so grateful that I can still breathe and have life, first of all. Amen. You see, because I should have been dead. Hallelujah. I should have been locked up in some mental institution, amen, for all the dope that I used, amen. But it was the mercy and the grace of God, amen, that showed up at the right time, glory to God. Hallelujah. Saved an old wretch like me, amen. Took me out of 30 years of crack cocaine addiction for a time such as this. Hallelujah. God is real. He is a powerful God. Hallelujah. Amen. There ain't no problem bigger than my God. Glory to God. Amen. Even though sometimes I think so, my God always shows up on time.
Amen. That's right.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
First of all, I just want to give honor to the churches that have supported Becoming Kingdom Ready in this past year. I'm an evangelist. I don't have a congregation, don't have a fellowship. This is my church. This is my home church. And I depend on God to move upon the hearts of people just like you. Amen. So I want to pray. I want to pray. Give honor to the churches. Amen. First of all, to show our appreciation, I'd like to show appreciation to Pastor Roberto and Sister Noelia. Would you please come to that to present this to you? La Iglesia de la Comunidad, they have been a very good blessing to us. When I first met Pastor Roberto and Sister Noelia, they didn't know me that long. They had just barely met me, but just because I stood for evangelistic outreach, they were really wanting a partner, and they were the ones who allowed us to have our first opening of prison doors outreach last year in their property, amen. And I just want to present this to your church, amen. And we thank you.
Wayne, you have been a blessing to us. Every time you step into our church, you always have something new. You always have that power and that spirit within you that always, always ministers to everyone that comes alongside you. And you have been a tremendous blessing to the youth of our church, ministering to them individually and as a group, and also ministering to families in our congregation. So you have been a blessing every time you set foot on our church. So we are grateful for you and your ministry.
Amen.
Thank you so much.
We know you're a man of God, and we really appreciate your ministry and all the help you have given us and your prayers, because I know that you have us in your prayers. And God uses you, and I hope that he continues using you for more and better, and so that he will accomplish the purpose that he has for your life.
Amen.
So just
Amen.
Wait upon him, because he's a
Thank
faithful
you,
God.
Yes.
Bless you.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Another ministry that has been very instrumental and supported our ministry, I want to right now acknowledge Pastor Roosevelt and Catherine Johnson of the Fountain of Love Ministries. Hallelujah. Praise God. Another mighty man and a mighty woman, a man and woman of God, amen, that have
also supported the ministry and has been very instrumental in moving things in the city, and amen, and just glad to have met you, amen. Here is, on behalf of Becoming Kingdom Ready, we want to give you and present you with this certificate of appreciation.
I just thank God for being here. God bless you, Evangelist Wayne. We thank God for what he's doing in your life.
Yes.
And I want to give honor to your lovely wife, because I know behind every good man, there's a good woman.
Amen.
And so I just want to thank the husband and the wife as a team. Amen.
Amen.
Because we know without God, this could not be possible at all. Amen. So we love you. Many times he have preached in our church. Amen. And that word is powerful. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So we just came to show our appreciation for this great man of God.
Amen.
Amen. Keep the good work up. Don't stop now. Hallelujah.
Pastor Wayne and his wife.
Amen.
They are faithful. Always on fire, Pastor Wayne. His wife's faith is strong, supporting him.
Hallelujah.
Just I've known him. It's been a privilege to be in your presence, because God is in your presence.
Hallelujah.
And your wife, God is with you always, and he's protecting you. He's supporting you.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Yes. He is the man you lean on, and you've been leaning on him since he pulled you out and blessed you.
Amen.
And you will have many more supporters, many more blessings, and greater heights.
Amen.
So we thank you for your love and for your interest, for supporting us too as well.
Amen.
And thank you, his wife. I don't know her name, I forgot her name, so many people. But I see her working. But you know, I love you.
Amen.
I love you, brother. You have a beautiful wife supporting you.
Evangelist Sister Tony. That's what I call her. Sister Evangelist Tony.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Praise God. Amen. Praise the Lord. God is good. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. You know, I just wanna acknowledge a man and a woman of God that's in the house that wasn't on the program. Pastor Steve and his lovely wife from the House of Refuge. It's another church here in the city of Highland Park. Pastor Steve, thanks for coming out with me. Hallelujah. There's another church that I like to acknowledge. Where is he? My pastor and his wife. I want to present the Smyrna Pentecostal Church with a certificate of appreciation. I thank God that God, you know, I've been in a few churches, amen. And what led me here is I met Pastor William in a meeting when I was still in the LA Mission. I had went to one of the community Northeast Pastor Randy's meetings over there. I think it was at some church over there. Come. And I met Pastor William there and stuff, and we talked and said hi and all that. But I had our outreach, when we had our outreach last year across the street, I asked Pastor William if he would interpret the message that we brought through the outreach.
Amen.
And it was a blessing, because I knew that the corporate anointing of God was in that place. Can you say amen? There were people, non-English speaking people in the audience, that when the altar call came, they came forward to receive the Lord through the interpretation, amen? So I knew that there was a corporate anointing, and then ever since then, God started to show me that this is the place where I needed to be, amen? And I'm gonna tell you, ever since I came to this church, I have grown spiritually. I've known a lot more about myself than I did before, and I just appreciate you and all that your wife and your at the church and my family here in Smyrna, mi familia aquí en esa iglesia, and this church, amen. Yeah, yeah. Amen.
Thank you. I just want to thank the Lord for Brother Wayne and his wife and the calling of God in your life. I see the burden that you have for the lost, for the youth, for those in prison, for people that many times are forgotten by the rest of the church. And something funny is that Brother Wayne tells me all the stories about his previous life before coming to the Lord, and many times I tell him, you know what? It's hard to believe it. Because I say, I didn't know that person, I just know Brother Wayne now. And I just praise the Lord because I know that God is powerful, that can transform the life of a person. Amen. And turn him around so much for his glory, for his glory, for his honor. And we're just so blessed to have you here in our church too. And he's a preacher, one of the preachers here at the church and helping us too. And you are also a blessing to this house and to this church and to our ministry. And we thank the Lord. And God is doing something wonderful in Highland Park here, our community. And I know that we as a ministry, we mostly do Spanish outreach, and we were missing that English outreach component. And you have been a blessing helping us out develop that in the church, so we're really happy. So we praise the Lord for that. Amen. Amen.
Amen. God bless. I just want to congratulate you, Brother Wayne, Pastor Wayne, because you are an example for those who want to work hard for the Lord. We see that you have been working so hard for the Lord, and we see that God is doing mighty ways through your life, and we thank God for that, and we congratulate you on this day. Thank you.
Praise God. But I want to give all the glory to God. I ain't done nothing, amen?
Amen.
Amen, I haven't, but I thank God. Hallelujah. Next, I like to recognize and honor those that have been faithful in our ministry, that have not a part of our ministry, but have been faithful in going with us to evangelize in certain areas, doing certain things. We have a convalescent ministry. We do convalescent every second. I've been doing that for over a year now, almost 2 years, as a matter of fact. And there has been some people that have been faithful coming out and going with us. We do the alumni services at the Los Angeles Mission every second Thursday or fourth Thursday of the month. They have been faithful. And so we also do a street evangelism training seminar in different locations. We've had two this year, one here and then one at the New Greater Victory Church of God in Christ. And we have a little team that have been faithful in doing the workshops and the seminar with us. So today I like to show our appreciation. Becoming Kingdom Ready likes to show our appreciation to Rashonda Craig Atkins for her dedication and what she has done. This certificate acknowledges your commitment to excellency and service. And we just want to show our appreciation. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Just over here. Also, I like to present, and you guys are probably wondering why he's standing here. He ain't doing nothing, right? Well, this is Danny. Danny is, I consider him my right-hand man. All right? So if the devil's going to throw something at me, I'm going to throw him in front. Amen. Hallelujah. I like to present our next certificate of appreciation to Brother Manuel Flores. Amen. We appreciate you, amen. Hallelujah. Becoming Kingdom Ready, a certificate of appreciation acknowledges your commitment to excellency and service. Amen. Amen. Brother Manuel, hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God. Praise the Lamb of God. He is good. Next, we like to present this certificate to Danny Espano. Miss Shelly Hernandez for her commitment to Bruce Shelly. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Shelly, I call her my kind of like administrative assistant. She's the administrative assistant. My wife is the executive administrative assistant. She does all the PowerPoints and all the looking up stuff for me. I appreciate you, Shelly, very much. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just to let you know, we're doing live streaming on the internet, amen. God is a good God. If you got some people out there, don't turn around and say hi. Just let them know. Amen. Next and foremost, this woman has been, actually she has perfect attendance in what going out with us to different locations. When we go to the LA Mission, she's always there. When we go to the convalescent home, she's always there. I think she only missed one time and she was in El Salvador. And this is to Sister Linda Pesco. Praise the Lamb of God. A mighty warrior, amen, a woman on fire for the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Sister Linda, Becoming Kingdom Ready acknowledges your commitment to excellency and service. Thank you very much. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Last but not least, I'd like to call my wife. You know, you always leave the best for the last. Can you say amen? And I'd like to just, this certificate doesn't even match how much junk she's put up with me with, amen? You know, I've known her since she was 14 years old. Amen. We have 5 children. We've been together for that long. She's seen me through 30 years of addiction, abuse, neglect. She's still standing there. Amen. Hallelujah. But I'm going to let her say something real quick before, okay?
First of all, thank you for everybody for being here today. We really appreciate it. Because he knows if I got this. You know what? God is good.
Yes.
I know a lot of you people cannot imagine him out there being a drug addict. And, you know, begging for money. But I thank God every day that I go out there and I don't have to see him on the corner, 7-Eleven, you know, asking for money or... And I thank God when I get off the bus at night at work, I'm thinking, praise the Lord. You know, I don't have to do it anymore.
Amen.
And so if you guys don't believe it, come and talk to me and I'll tell you.
I know.
Probably more than you want me to, but I'll come and tell you. Yeah, but God is good. We just want to say, oh, we know that. And we're going to keep on going forward because the best is yet to come.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. Can we get a group picture, please? A group picture. This is my team right here. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Okay. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
One more?
No, amen. Praise God. Come on, let's give the Lord some praise. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God is good. Amen. Praise his holy name. Hallelujah. Dwight to come. He's going to bring the word today. I want you to stand to your feet and give this man of God a round of applause. Amen. For the Jesus that's in him. Amen. He's awesome. Amen. And I just thank you. Hallelujah.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Jesus is Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Every knee shall bow to him.
Amen.
Amen. Since I'm in the presence of greatness, I'd like to give honor to God, who is Lord alone. I give you greetings. I bring you greetings from Bible Enrichment Fellowship International Church, where my apostle, the great Beverly Van Crawford, in the city of Englewood, is the apostle of that house. I want to give honor to Pastor Williams and all the pastors. Amen. It's in the house. God bless you and keep you. And I'd like to acknowledge my beautiful wife, Catherine Gale. Amen. When Evangelist Turner shares about our past, just thank God for Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
We thank God for Jesus and the Holy Ghost saving some people. Amen.
Amen.
I want to acknowledge also Brother Maurice, Minister Maurice, and his beautiful wife, Dolores, that are powerhouses in the house of God. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. This is a beautiful sanctuary. Amen. Thank God for the Pentecostal assemblies. Thank God for Ecclesiastic Smyrna Church, that the doors open. Me and my wife in Los Angeles, we always see a church every time we go by, they're just worshiping God. And I say, we need to go get in there and get in that atmosphere. Mm. Amen. And I don't know what's happening with the black and browns that they talk about in Lancaster, but God is doing a new thing. Amen.
Yeah.
And he won't leave himself without a witness. I'm trying not to be before you too long. Beware when those preachers say that. Amen. But I know everybody loves Jesus, and I know we all have things to do. So I just want to bring open the word of life to you, amen, and share with my brothers and sisters in Christ that we may be encouraged and edified. Evangelist Turner, I want to commend you and Minna for doing a great work in the kingdom. Amen.
Yes.
I heard he said that the best is yet to come.
Amen.
Amen. And we know for every level there's a devil.
All right.
Amen. But I want you to remember that the devil is a liar and his house is on fire.
Amen.
And don't let a loser win in your life.
All right.
Amen. The Bible says that if we get a chance to see what he looked like, we're going to be kind of shocked that this is the ones that stirred up the nations. Amen. But Jesus Christ is Lord. And greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. Amen. I want to talk today about the hundredfold leader. And if you have your Bible, I want to speak a little bit from Mark chapter 4, and then I'm going to close with Evangelist Turner theme for the third anniversary. You have to excuse me, I will walk around a little bit because that's kind of like how I flow, Pastor William. You know, I just kind of walk around. I'm reading from the Word of God, but I do have this iPad here that I took my notes on because my wife could tell you, if you've seen my handwriting, you know, you would. I need the iPad just to understand my own handwriting. Amen. Praise God. But let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, no flesh shall glory in your presence. I thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, as John the Baptist once proclaimed, "I must decrease so you can increase. In my flesh dwells nothing good." But I pray, Lord, in the name of Jesus, and thank you that the words of my lips and the meditations of my house, I thank you that this is an anointed house. I thank you, Lord, that the messenger and angel is anointed. All the ministers are anointed. We're too blessed to be stressed. We're too anointed to be disappointed. And we're too equipped to be whipped. Only because of you, Lord, we give you praise and glory. I thank you that the gifts are in full operation. I thank you, Father God, for this apostolic house. I thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that your word would not return unto you void, but accomplish that which you please and sent out for it to do. In Jesus' name, I pray, Father God, and thank you for the laying on of hands with Evangelist Turner and Mina. I thank you for the leaders that you use to sow into their lives. And I thank you, Lord, for fruit that lasts. I pray, Lord, that every minister, every usher, every member in this house, at the sound of my voice and their congregations, I pray that we all will finish well. Keep us, Lord. That our love for you would not grow cold. Keep us from apostasy. Keep us from hypocrisy. Keep us from legalism. Keep us from self-righteousness. Keep us from carnality, Lord. And help us to never be ashamed of the name that is above every name. That at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow to you. Every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. To the glory of God the Father. We bless you and honor you, Lord, and give you reverence. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
In Mark chapter 4, you may be familiar with the parable of the sower. The Bible says in chapter 4, verse 8, I like to start. Jesus is telling a spiritual story, and he's telling a parable to his disciples and followers. And they always say that the simple meaning of a parable is a physical story that has spiritual meaning. And so Jesus is telling this story because a lot of people, especially even those that we deal with today, they have ears to hear, but they still don't understand. And I thank God for the evangelists. Evangelists, you mentioned something about not having a church. Well, you know, most of the time, evangelists, true evangelists, don't have no church.
Amen.
Because they go out winning souls. But they always partnership with the church because then people are supposed to be in the church. After people get saved, when people accept Jesus Christ and rededicate their life and they don't go inside the church, there's a question about genuine conversion. Because the Jesus promised this, that the gates of hell should not prevail against the church. The gates of hell will prevail against everything else but the church. Everybody needs a pastor. Hip-hoppers need a pastor. Rich folks need a pastor. And so you can't be astounded when you run into celebrities because really God might give you a word to set them free and to lead them into a path of righteousness. Because you know broad and wide is the road that leads to destruction. And many people, you know, we have a saying in Los Angeles, hell is low, but you don't have to go. Hey, that's some real deep theology right there, y'all. You just, listen, you're not judging nobody, but hell is low, but you don't have to go. So you have to put the ball back in their hands where they can at least say, well, what am I going to do with that? That was pretty deep right there, Pastor Steve. Hell is low, but I don't have to go. Thank God. I don't know about y'all, but I was bringing speed records to hell. If you just go back down memory lane, because I know that Evangelist Turner has a testimony, but all of us have a testimony. And sometimes the Holy Ghost will give you a word to give somebody about your past, because your past will help set somebody free. See, sometimes we want to act like we've been in the church all our lives, but we really need to tell the truth sometimes, because it might help somebody, because most of the people outside of the church can't relate to people in the church, because they're too sanctimonious. Sometimes you got to make some impact so you can make, you got to make some contact so you can make some impact. I tell you, when he broke my heart, I must have lost my mind. Well, you might catch about 10 or 11 followers after that cap right there. People can identify with divorce. You know, you got to tell the truth and shame the devil. The devil's accusing of the brethren, but see, don't let him tell the truth on you.
Amen.
See, something about deliverance, and that's why they have support groups, because sometimes when you tell people certain things, it frees you up. The devil can't accuse you of that.
That's right.
That's why you gotta continue to walk in truth. I'm not talking about telling everybody your life story, but sometimes you get an unction from your belly that you need to go ahead and say this so somebody can get healed. Do I have any witnesses in the house? Amen. I'm trying not to be before you too long, but amen. God is good and he's worthy to be praised.
Amen.
The clock, I know somebody might, is it any games on tonight? I know we are spiritual, but you know, sometimes we do live in these human bodies and we get tired and some of us got to go to work on Monday and Some of us have to go to work so we can pay some bills.
Tell the truth.
Amen. They got real gangsters out there. T-Mobile and Time Warner. Everybody know them gangsters? Organized crime. Nordstrom Rack. Macy's. Organized. Get delivered. Get delivered. Get delivered. Look what it says here. Mark chapter 4, verse 8. And other seed fell into the good soil, and they grew up and increased. They yielded a crop and produced 30, 60, and 100 fold. Go down to verse 11 with me. And he was saying to them, to you has been given the mystery of the kingdom of God, but those who are outside get everything in parables, in order that while seeing they may see and not perceive, and while hearing they may hear and not understand, lest they return and be forgiven. And he said to them, do you not understand this parable, and how will you understand all the parables? The sower sows the word. And these are the ones who are beside the road where the word is sown. And when they hear, immediately Satan comes and takes away the word which has been sown in them. And in a similar way, these are the ones to whom seed was sown on the rocky places, who when they hear the word, immediately receive it with joy, and they have no firm root in themselves, but are only temporary. Then, when affliction or persecution arises because of the word's sake, immediately they fall away. And others are the ones to whom seed was sown among the thorns. These are the ones who have heard the word, and the worries of this world, the deceitfulness of riches, the desires for other things enter in and choke the word, and it becomes unfruitful. And these are those that are sown on good ground, whom seed was sown on good soil. They hear the word and accept it and bear fruit, 30, 60, and 100 fold. I want to talk today to you about 100 fold leadership, Evangelist Turner, and for all the leaders in the house. I know everybody is a leader because the Bible says that, see, we in Christianity, we believe in the priesthood of believers. We believe that when people get saved and come into the church and a disciple, they become, there's a priesthood of believers. That means every Christian is really a minister of God. Every Christian has a ministry of reconciliation. I know that a lot of people need, I know we have to be patient and people need to be discipled. But evangelists, as you continue in ministry, you're meeting, you're going to see and you're going to witness people that are these kind of souls in their heart. This is what's happening in the lives of people that we minister to, people that we live next door to, people that we work with. These are some of the things that we're going, that they're going through in their life. When I think about the fivefold, when I think about hundredfold, I think about the fivefold ministry.
Yes.
And in the fivefold ministry, it says in Ephesians that God has ascended and he's also ascended, and then he gave gifts unto men and women. See, God is no respecter of persons, amen? Amen. Don't think that, you know, everybody may not be called to the pulpit, but there is a pulpit for you, amen? You might be called to the marketplace ministry. You might become the CEO of an organization that hires people and help families stay together. That may be your anointing and calling, amen? Your anointing might just be praying for children as they go to school, but you do have a ministry of reconciliation. Now, the fivefold ministry, the pastor is usually the shepherd that oversees the people as they labor with the word.
Yes.
Because, you know, one thing about ministering the word of God, evangelist, is that when people hear the word of God, something is going to happen.
Yes.
God's word will not return it to him. Boy, when you minister the word of God, don't be too, you know, not feel that you're ever moderate because you use the word of God.
Yes.
They got a generation doors that's almost gone. They have a generation of women that used to, matter of fact, let me just tell the truth. If the women would almost boycott the church, most churches almost were closed down.
Oh, yeah. Amen.
I probably apologize. I don't know what it means, but I don't know. But if it wasn't for the last decades, the prayers of the women in the church and the giving of the women in the church doors would be closed down. And so then there's the apostles. The apostles were commissioned by Jesus Christ to go preach the gospel, go teach, and also to baptize. Amen? So sometimes when you're preaching and teaching and you're baptized, sometimes you're moving in apostolic. Yeah. Isn't it amazing? Check this out. Isn't it amazing if you go back in church history how the church started as a Pentecostal church, and then it ended up a couple hundred years later in the Catholic?
Yes.
Isn't it amazing? How the church started Pentecostal. They met up in one room and started speaking in tongues. And then you don't hear me though. The church started, and then 1600 years later, the Dark Ages came along, and the church was almost dead.
Come on now.
You don't hear me though. I'm talking about church history. And if you ain't careful, the devil will try to put the lights out, but Jesus has promised that the gates of hell should not prevail. We might be getting older and our back might be hurting and our hair might be falling out, but you're still anointed, baby. Amen. You gotta talk to yourself sometime and you gotta look in the mirror and say, I'm still sold out, Jesus. I still love you. I still gonna lay hands today. I'm still gonna cast out some demons today. Young people need to be righteous or bold as a lion. Young folks, you gotta get bold, you gotta get sold out. Don't wait till you get like grandma to get sold out. You better get sold out now, baby. You better surrender. Amen. When the pastor said, when they have altar call, listen, you don't need nobody to invite you to the altar. You need to come break down here to the altar on your own 2 feet. I apologize. I didn't want to make no enemies of that.
Make some.
Hundredfold leaders.
Hundredfold leaders.
And then the evangelist goes out there under the anointing of the evangelist, and he preaches the gospel, the good news. God's story. Everybody needs to know what the good news is. It is the life, the death, the burial, the resurrection of Jesus Christ. I can't save nobody, but if you believe the gospel, it's able to turn a drug addict into a preacher. If you believe the gospel, is able to take a prostitute and make her into a ministry. Power in the gospel. You got to keep telling the story. Baby, do you know Jesus? You got to keep telling the story. See, sometimes we try to rationalize and reason with people, and the first thing they need to do is be saved. You can't reason with demons. You don't talk to demons. You tell demons what to do. I'm not calling people demons, but you got to exercise some authority and some discernment. You can tell a demon by its works. People lying all the time and cussing folks out. That's a demon. People still, and check this out. Listen, it's not that your children, but check this out. The demons, if they can't get at you, they're going to come at your children.
Come on, minister.
Yes. I went to Wanda Turner the other day, and she said, listen, he said, when Job offered sacrifices to God for his children, and that's before the whirlwind came. And you and I got to keep worshiping God and keep standing in the presence of God for our children.
Yes.
Do I have any witnesses here?
Amen.
You got to stand in worship. You got to be in proxy, baby. Job said, though he slay me, yet will I trust him. You can't be no fair weather Christian, baby. When you're serving God, when you come to the altar, when you come inside the church, you come to do business. We don't come to entertain in the church. We come to worship. Worship, with worship, we get our assignment. That's how we get our orders. You got to get in the presence of God. It's corporate worship and it's private worship. And don't be in there worshiping God and go out there living like the devil. I'm sorry, I'm just a little drunk with the Holy Ghost. I don't know about y'all, but it's too late for the ministers to be sitting down and pastors. It is too late in the game. Everybody needs to be worshiping God. If you come out of your shoes, jump on a chair, jump on a chandelier, get you some worship in. some offering for Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. These are some last times, evangelists. These are some perilous times. We ain't playing church no more. It's too late to be playing church. We're dealing with some end time demons. We're dealing with some demons that don't care. It is a steal from the church, put a writing on the church, everything. Baby, we dealing with some end time demons. Witchcraft is trying to come into church. People practicing sorcery, palm reading, everything else. We dealing with some end time demons. We dealing with some sophisticated demons. Sometimes you just gotta lose yourself to get in the presence of God. I was trying to get to my message. I don't know where all this message came from. I don't know, but you gotta speak to the church. You gotta equip God's people for end time warfare. Let me tell you, listen, you had the heart of a gunslinger on the streets. You used to drink and act crazy and sleep whatever you want to. And now when you come to church, you wanna be all nice and frisky. Baby, you better stay on fire. You better get on fire and stay on fire. You got to fight for your marriage. You got to fight for your mind, baby. You got to fight to stay holy. I don't know, evangelist. I don't know, but let me eventually get to, you know, I'm trying not to be before you too long, because I'm tired. I know y'all, everybody want to go home, you know? But the enemy uses that same old trick. Did God really say that? That's why you got to know the word. You got to meditate on the word. You got to live the word. You got to get saturated in the word. That word is anointing, baby. That word will teach you all things. You know, you just don't understand how powerful this word is. You be reading it and you think you just had a little light Bible studies with daily bread. And you, when you get off work, you wonder, why am I going in this direction? That word is anointed, baby. That word will speak to your heart. He sent his word to heal us. You have faith in that word when you put that word out. You ain't gonna pray, don't worry. If you're gonna worry, don't pray. You got to believe God's word. Let me tell you something. He said heaven and earth will pass away before his word passes away. You gotta stand on that word. You gotta confess that word. The Lord, my God shall supply all of my needs according to his riches and glory in Christ Jesus. I'm the head and not the tail. I'm blessed to be, I'm blessed going out. The devil is a liar. I'm giving myself to God. I'm gonna resist the devil so he can flee. If you think the devil is just gonna sit back and let you just do all kind of ministry. If you think the devil just gonna fold his hand, arms, and legs while you just sit back and do ministry. And let me tell you something, it ain't always the devil sometimes. The devil ain't just coming to your house all the time. You ain't that bad. But I know when Jesus was in the wilderness, the devil came to him personally. 40 days and 40 nights. But check this out now. Since he can't come to Jesus, he will send a demon or imp your way. The devil only tempts you in the areas of your weakness.
Come on.
He ain't tempting you in your prayer life, your fasting life. If you're managing your money right, see, some of us are saying that we ain't got no money. Listen, you gotta stop that confession, then you gotta start managing your money. Money is a good servant, but it's a hard taskmaster. You got to live by the word. You can't just quote it, baby. You got to put some work in. Recovery say it works if you work it. The word of God is true. And then you got to start paying some tithes, too. Everybody want to know why? First thing you got to do, investigation. You ain't paying no tithes, are you? Pastor Williams, you know what I'm saying? The last days, you know, some folks think they can just live any kind of way they want to. Ain't nobody want to obey the word no more. Let me tell you something. They say that in America, there is a gross number of biblical illiteracy. Yeah. That means people don't know the word of God. Yeah. That's why people end up drinking purple Kool-Aid, because they don't. You, when a man of God, when a man or woman say something contrary to the word, you got to know the word for yourself. Got to get on your knees and, you know, always pastor. You know, some saints really bold. They go pastor, you know, about that last message you spoke on the other day. I'm trying to find that scripturally. Can you break it down for me? Because
I don't see it, but maybe the Lord speak to the head, and I don't know, but I could really get an understanding. If I get an understanding, I could probably go do it, you know? Amen. Man, I don't know about y'all, but I'm going to be, I'm going to be sold out, you know? I'm going to go ahead and serve Jesus, amen? Evangelist, to the casket drop. Amen. He can attack my son. He can attack my family. He can attack my body. But I'm going to serve Jesus to the casket. I'm going to pray. Go in the hospital 3 days. Everybody going to get saved. Doctor going to get saved. Nurse going to get saved. I'm going to walk out healed in Jesus' name. God said, I just asked you there for a second. I just asked you on assignment. So you don't understand some of the rough places you get in. You might just be on assignment. And sometimes God has to take that foolishness out of us. Amen. See, that 17 years, baby, sanctification. Get that foolishness out of you. Amen. So when he exalts you, you won't bring reproach to his name. Amen. See, some things we're going through, it ain't the devil, it's God. Yes. Getting that foolishness out of you.
Yes.
I follow God. You know, you got to have this. Pastor Steve, you got to have these nice messages now, you know? Don't nobody want to talk about sin. I'm going to get to the text sooner or later. Listen, I didn't say everything I didn't type already, so it won't be long. Jesus is the master teacher. Got some water here? Amen. I'm on fire. God is not the author of confusion. You can always see clear when you look at Jesus. He's the author and finisher of our faith. So let me hear. Here's the kind of people Jesus said. Here's something that the devil is going to come and try to steal the word immediately. That's why King David said, Lord, I put your word in my heart doors, so I will not sin against you. You got to get God's word inside of you. You got to get it in your heart. Because the more Wesley said this, it was Spurgeon, one of them. The Bible will keep you away from sin, and sin will keep you from the Bible. Now, I don't know if any of y'all might, you might look at memory lane, but all of us were there at one time.
Yes.
We seen, boy, that preacher sure preach. What he talking about? I don't know. You know, and we go back out there, and I don't know if our life got too much changed, but God was working on us because his word will not return it to us. You got to speak that word to your children. I know they think you're crazy already anyhow. Listen, it's my house. Who's paying the bills? Sometimes you got to give people a reality check. Sometimes you can't just tell your children no. You got to tell them hell no.
Amen. That's right.
Let me tell you something. Don't submit to your children if they are guided and controlled by demons.
That's right.
If they're crazy, you just have to commit them to the Lord. You have to commit your children to the Lord. Keep on going to church. Keep on fasting. Keep on praying. Keep on tithing and just trust Him. God can do what people can't do. I'm telling you, these kids are going crazy.
Come on,
it's a demonic. It's we live in it. I'm telling you, this is. Listen, it's in warfare, baby.
Come on.
It's in warfare. It's warfare. It's warfare. The devil trying to break your spirit. Trying to get you all tired and worn out. You come to church and try to do everything. Sometimes the acronym for busy is being under Satan.
What I like to do is I like to challenge you to come alongside Becoming Kingdom Ready and partner with us monthly. As you will see from the slideshow that's next, God has taken us a long place or a long way in a short period of time. Can you say amen?
Amen.
You see, this past year, God has opened the door for us to go into two countries.
Yes.
Two countries to preach the gospel. Never thought I was gonna leave a little village. Never thought I was gonna leave Los Angeles. We were able to work with the youth through our Facing Giants youth support group. Our prison ministry was able to reach out to inmates throughout the U.S. And I believe our furthest one is in the state of Illinois. The opening of Prison Doors Outreach 2012 was a blessing as we had the first job fair here in Highland Park in 7 years. Hello. You see, in September of 2011, we broadcasted our first show from the Becoming Kingdom Ready radio show. Hello.
Hello.
You see, and just recently we just started a series on the show on deliverance and inner healing. Pastor William was my co-host, and it was an honor and a privilege to have him there. This show has had such a high response of responses, and we would like to keep it on the air. Now, That's just some of the things that God has done through this ministry. In this upcoming year, I believe God for far greater things. Hello, somebody. You see, the first thing I'm trusting God for is an office where I can work from and where I can meet people. Hello, somebody. I have already begun providing job referrals for some of our community members. I have started to document the services that I now have through the many resources that God has provided for this ministry. Can you say amen? And I intend to do more community outreach to our at-youth risk in this neighborhood. You see, through mentorship, vocational training, I have a lot of referrals for those vocational training, but not to mention drug counseling, as I'm a certified substance abuse counselor today, and it's only by the grace of God. And I want to support their families, amen? Now, these are just a few things that God has placed in my heart for this upcoming year. But becoming kingdom ready needs your support. Hello, nobody leave yet. Becoming kingdom ready needs your support. Since I don't have a congregation and this is an evangelistic ministry, I have to trust totally on the Lord to move upon people like you. People that have a heart for the kingdom of God and its advancement through evangelism. People that would be willing to sow seed into fertile ground. Hello, you see? So please watch this presentation, and after that, we'll be picking up an offering. But I would like to challenge you today to commit and becoming a partner financially monthly with us, amen, to support this ministry so that God would be able to use us to take the gospel into the entire world.
I give myself away. I give myself away. So you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away. So you can. Come on, let him know. I give myself away. I give myself away. So you can use me. I give myself away.
What would happen? It's a generation.